In this tutorial video, we're going to learn how to create sprite animation using sprites that we've downloaded from GameArt2D.com. They have a bunch of free sprites that you can download, as well as tile sets to create cool parallax scrolling backgrounds and other game interface graphics. So in this particular tutorial video, I'm going to download the zombie and the knight because I need a hero and a villain. And you never know, the zombies could be the hero and the knight could be the villain. It's up to you. And then I'm going to download the free graveyard tile set just to create a cool parallax background. But in this particular video, we're going to concern ourselves more with the sprites. So if I click on this particular sprite, you'll see this, which is called our sprite sheet. And what it shows is that each sequence, so this is the idle sequence, includes a number of different poses that when put together in an animated sequence, actually show that characteristic. So for instance, this has 10 different images that when it's put together in animation show the idle sequence. So like if somebody is not pressing the key on their controller or the key on their keypad and the character is just standing there, it doesn't just stand there frozen, it should do something. So whether he's, you know, slightly moving and sort of huffing through his breath, whatever it may be, we want him to have some sort of movement so that we know that he's active and not frozen and the game is not broken. So we also have walk sequences, run sequences, attack, jump, jump attack, dead, etc. And each one of these we can tie with code to a particular key on your keyboard or a button on a controller so that when somebody hits A on a controller, we can make it attack. And every time they hit A, it's going to run through this sprite sequence. Okay. So after we've downloaded all of these assets in Animate CC, we've created a new project, and this is an ActionScript 3.0. It's 24 frames per second because we want smooth animation, and I've made it 1280 by 720. And again, you can choose your own stage size. I tend to stick to the YouTube video dimensions because those are pretty standard sizes. This one is a good size, but it's right below the high definition size. So it's going to still give me good quality and a good size without being too massive. All right. In this, I have a background layer where I've added a ground and a background. It's lame. It doesn't look cool, but I'm going to add my parallax scrolling background later. For now, this is just placeholder so that I can see the ground in which I want my knight to run. With that created, I locked it down so I didn't have to change anything or put anything on that layer that could confuse things. Now, I've already done one of these sequences so we can see what this looks like. I'll hit Command or Control and Return, Command Return or Control Enter, depending on if you're a Mac or PC. So as you can see, we have this walk sequence, and this consists of 10 different images in a movie clip that when put together, that constant loop is going to create this walk sequence. So if I double click inside of this guy, you can see that we are in a movie clip called Knight Walk. So I always try to name it by the character and then the particular sequence. And then we have on frame one, the first pose, frame two, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, and tenth. Okay, so let's see how to do this with a new sequence. For right now, I'll go ahead and lock and turn off the visibility of the Knight Walk layer. And go ahead and create, let's do Knight Attack. Okay, so let's go back over to our downloaded assets and make sure these come as zip files. So extract them on a Mac, you'll double click and extract them. And if you're on a PC, I think you right click on the zip file and choose unzip. All right, so you see this Dragon Bones layer and it has all the different parts in the original project file. Now, if you are doing your own character in Adobe Illustrator, just make sure that each pose is on its own layer, but they are stacked in a perfect stacking order. Don't put them side by side. You want them to be right on top of each other. And make sure that you name them all with the same name of the sequence. And then notice that this one has chronological order with parentheses for each one. Make sure you do that. Okay, so I'm going to find the attack sequence, so I'll click the first one, hold shift, and click the last one. This allows me to grab all 10 of those actions and drag them simultaneously into my Animate CC project. Now, if yours can't do that for some reason, remember that you can always go to File, import and choose import to stage and choose all 10 of those actions. Now it's really important when you do this that you don't start moving all these little 10 sequences around or 10 images around, because we want to actually have all of these stacked perfectly the way they are, and we want to put them all into a movie clip. So we're going to click off, and then we're going to click and drag. And I know that seems like why would you do that again, because it looks the exact same thing. But what it did the last time is it only selected the top one, and it would only put the top pose into the movie clip symbol, and that would cause problems. So when you do this, make sure to click off and then marquee select to grab all of those different poses, all 10 of them, so that they all go into the movie clip. So we'll go up to modify, convert to symbol, and we're going to make sure it says movie clip and MC Knight attack. Okay. So once you do that, you can double click to get inside of that movie clip, and now you can see that we are in the movie clip of Knight Attack, which is in scene one, and we only have one layer. Now, again, I'm going to click off and marquee select to make sure I've selected all of them in that stack, right click and choose distribute to layers. When you do that, it's going to automatically distribute all of those poses to their own layer. And then that layer one where everything used to be, you can go ahead and click the trash button to delete it. All right. So now that we have this all stacked perfectly, we need to make sure that our attack pose one is on frame one. And then our next frame, our next keyframes are moved down in a stacked, staggered manner. So to do this, I'll go ahead and click once and then click and drag each keyframe so that it creates that staggering. So I'm just going to make sure it goes in a stair step pattern. All right, so each one of these, so we're not working from the top down because frame or pose one is the one we should start with. And since that's on frame one, that's the one we start with. Okay, drag that down. And then we can see what this looks like by going back out to scene one. Now, if I turn on the walk, he's going to kind of be in my way. So I'm going to go ahead and move this over. And now again, Command Return or Control Enter. And now you can see that attack sequence. Now I've slowed his down by adding a little bit of time. So I'll show you how I did that here. I may not want that for my attack, but I just want to show you what I did with that. So let's go into walk so we can see it. And you can see that the first pose is on frame one, but then on frame one, we still have the first pose. Then on frame two, we have the new pose, and we have it last for one extra frame. And that kind of slowed it down without making our animation choppy by changing the frame rate. So let's go back into our Knight Attack and see how we can do this. So it's just a matter of clicking and dragging and creating that extra space. And if you do this, you're probably not going to have that extra keyframe or that extra frame at the end. And I'll show you what that looks like without it. And then you can see how to fix it. Okay. All right. So now if we go ahead and do Command Return, you can see that he kind of looks like he's in a strobe light because it's missing all those extra frames. So if we come to frame one, we can see the pose. We go to frame two and he disappears. Frame three, we see pose two, then he disappears. So we need to actually have frame one or pose one last for two frames and pose two last for two frames and pose three last for two frames, etc. So for each one of these, I can click here. I can choose right click, insert frame, or I can go up to insert timeline frame, or I can just hit F5 on my keyboard. If you have a condensed keyboard, you might need to like hit function and then F5 or use the right click. So don't forget to add an extra frame so that it loops properly between this 20th frame back around to the first frame and it'll look good that way. So Command Return. And now you should see that attack sequence a little bit slower, a little bit smoother. Now, I probably, again, wouldn't change that. I would probably go back to before where he's a lot faster because he's not going to kill anybody with that kind of slow chop that he's got going on there. But for the walk, slowing it down really did help for him. So for the dash or the run sequence, if he has one of those, I'm not going to probably slow it down. But the dead sequence, I might slow it down because he's going to do a dramatic death that takes forever. So each one of these is just a matter of creating each of these sequences. You can create 1, 2, 3, or all of them. And then you just want to combine them in the main timeline animation. And we'll see that in Sprite Animation Part 2.